Hello! Welcome back to Planet Coaster. This is The Great Tree, which is the first of three of the, fairy tale things? I think it's fairy tale. Either way, they say this tree is the heart of the world. Can you respect Mother Nature and craft an eco-friendly theme park around the towering tree, or will you I can't see that anymore. Well, you guys can read the rest of that. I was apparently too slow for my own recording. I could fix that. Re-record the start here, but whatever, I'm not going to, because I'm a professional, not really at all. But this is the park we start with. It's got this really neat, like, underground... I don't really know what to call this, but it looks really neat, and I'm fond of it. But the only ride you have is that one ride. It's a little dinky thrill ride, I guess. I don't know, it could probably be a family ride. But it's also got this really neat tree. And this tree is actually made of just the terrain. There's nothing fancy about it. There's no, apart from the lights and like the doors and stuff, there's no scenery stuff. It's just the land carved to look like a tree. And I thought my camera glitched into the ground there. If you're curious why I'm doing that, look at them textures. But yeah, that's your park. That's the whole park. You got these really weird winding paths that I assume is meant to look sort of like a... They're branching paths. It looks sort of like a tree or a root system or something like that, a branching system. This is the entrance. I really like the entrance. I really like the theming on all of these campaign parks so far. This one's relatively simple, but either way. The objectives here are relatively simple, except for the build-a-coaster one. If you're like me and are new to the game, that could prove to be tricky. The other ones you'll just get naturally. Particularly the park rating you'll get naturally just from having the scenery rating as well. Basically just put a lot of trees, props and buildings and all sorts of other stuff like that. And you'll get that scenery rating relatively easily. But the coaster's tricky. And that will happen, I will get that objective way at the very end of this video. So if that's what you're looking for, you can just jump to that. Or I can give you... a little information on how to do it. Essentially what it's asking for is a coaster that has, or exactly what it's asking for, is a coaster that has 5 excitement, 5 fear, and 5 seconds of airtime. Now what it means by airtime, obviously it's a coaster, it's not going to be physically in the air detached from the track because that will kill people, generally. So what it means by that is essentially it wants your G's, your vertical G's to be negative for 5 seconds total on the ride, which took me a little bit to figure out. You'll see me later in this video screwing around building absurd silly tracks. I think I might have cut that out, I'm not entirely sure, but later in the video or between the end of the video and like halfway through, I was screwing around trying to build really strange looking coasters because I was not being understanding of what exactly I wanted by 5 seconds of airtime because I'm an idiot. What else is new, I suppose, but essentially what you just need is a coaster with a lot of bumps. That's all it's asking. It just needs a coaster with, like, I think 6 or 7 hills will do it, and you'll reach 5 seconds from that. And then essentially just need to... That should make it fairly close to 5 excitement and 5 fear in and of itself, but if not, you can do some wiggles. Some additional hills beyond the 5 seconds of airtime if need be. Having known this, it's not a particularly difficult... I also had issues with this piece of pathway, by the way. I don't know why it wouldn't attach, but it was very picky. If you have issues with this roller coaster thing, just remember that it just wants the track to be wiggly, essentially. That's all it's asking for. Pardon all the fast-forwarding in and out of terrain and stuff like that for this one. I was just messing around there. And the whole, you know, post-commentary thing. Oh yeah, if I didn't mention it already, this is the second of 2, hopefully just 2, videos wherein I recorded incorrectly and had it set up so it was recording my voice with push to talk, which obviously I was not pushing the button to talk. So... a little bit of a goof there, so I'm having to do post-commentary, which will not encompass the entire video. And of course, there's going to be a lot of fast-forwarding in the video and stuff like that. The music playing right now is just music from the game's soundtrack. Nothing fancy or anything like that. Well, I mean, it is nice music, but it is from the game, so... If you're curious where it's from, you can Google it. I believe it's on... Planet Coaster's YouTube page, I think. So shouldn't be terribly hard to find. I'm pretty sure you can just search for Planet Coaster soundtrack and it'll pop up from their channel, which is nice of them. I like when companies do that. Anyway, that's pretty much all there is to this one. Just put down a lot of scenery. You don't start with a loan in this one, so you've got time to just idly make money if you want. It's a thing. This is the coaster I actually built for this one. This is not the coaster that meets the requirements of 5 excitement, 5 nausea. It was nausea, not fear. And 5 seconds of airtime. This is just a coaster that I built attempting to meet those requirements that did not meet those requirements, but I used for income, so I kept it. Kind of mediocre stats also. This is a wooden coaster that can go down at an 81 degree angle, which I don't think is something a roller and wooden coaster should be capable of doing, but that's a thing, I suppose. Either way, this is the coaster I built. It makes some money. The stats are kind of mediocre because I don't do nearly enough over bank turns and stuff like that, or loops or, you know, helixes or anything. I don't do nearly enough of that. My coasters are kind of basic, but they make money hand over fist most of the time, so I'm usually fairly alright with them. It takes me a little bit to make this one because I'm screwing around with a hill that's honestly much too large for a wooden coaster. I mean, it looks nice, but the stats on it are ridiculous. I think I do an autocomplete here just to do something. I don't remember exactly what I did, but I basically reworked this entire coaster at some point. I could have edited this part out, but it's not too long, and maybe you guys will enjoy the music. So yeah, the only difficult part of this park is the 555 coaster. If you're having difficulties, you can't get, you know, maybe you have the right amount of airtime, but you can't get the excitement high enough or something like that for whatever reason. There are several on the Steam Workshop that you can use. You can use them at your leisure if you require it. So that's a thing. But either way, that's really the only difficult part. Once you build a coaster, you're basically rolling in money as long as the coaster is decent. It doesn't even have to be good, it just needs to be decent. So, like this one. This one's a decent coaster. It's not great. Well, ignoring this part because I remake this one because I don't like the stats that come out of it. Pretty sure I just delete like the entire coaster and I'm like, yeah, I'll just start over. Anyway, the next video will be back to your regularly scheduled me being an idiot with live commentary instead of me being an idiot with post commentary. So I hope you guys are excited looking towards that. Words are hard. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time wherein we do the second, I think it's Kingdom Tale, wherein we do the second mission in this particular themed campaign. So we'll see how that goes. Thanks for watching, see you guys then.